we will officially invite you to come and address the county assembly. And in this regard, because you are the one who's in charge, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, gentlemen.
From the activists that proposed to come at the back to have and send a note to the Public Service Commission about transport remuneration. I remember that night that I drove all the way to Ben and the room in the morning to go and talk to one of the union leaders who had been calling the hotel in one hotel. I don't know the region, and it was a success. It was a name of me, and Spoda, and the leadership, and all the year with you, and all that happened in the morning. To the people who were at this organization. Now, what about this? This court case, it has been known that there are some irregularities in the legal transfer, and we have these days to realize that. I actually think that the judge knows. We had actually passed the Bill of Transfer on this law. We had a voting committee that had looked at the Bill of Transfer and we passed it here. So what that means is, what that means is that if someone succeeds in disrupting the state of the first family for the next 6 months, then the NMS will be totally equal. And that's what happened in general for last night. That the people want to disrupt the assembly and move in this card, and then the lesson from the informed office is to stop the organization that they will bring their budgets and now ask the money, whatever the money has been allocated, not the money that the investment that has been allocated from the president, that was one of us, but they also want to disrupt the assembly so that we can stay away for the next 90 years, and then we can last. The time that the judge has given us, and then we imagine in the world of the wishes that that's when we can have the transfer. This is now new and more. The deal of transfer is here for the time that was signed. We were not there when we signed it. It was not even our wish, but it is here. It is our duty. We have to consume it, and we have to see it grow, we have to see it work. I was in the UNC system. It is no one who spoke last month in the MCs. It is no one who promised the president through some sense that we are going to support him 140%. I think there are going to be different. I must remember that. Every last day was added to me in this book. When people were talking there that day, we are all going to be different. We are going to support it. And we have been given that we are going to support us. In case you don't do anything, we should have been taken to the ask you to do when you show the problem you. So what's the problem is, you're very grateful, and after you speak to him, you find out what you want to come and what you do, what you think, something more like it.
Always being there to consult and ask us what is happening, how can I engage with the honorable members, how can we move forward, and I think the honorable member of Central Town is one proud member who I believe today can see he has seen now the development in his world. I think for the last 2 years we have been on ups and downs in this Nairobi county in terms of census. And generally, by the time the president felt this was the best way to move, I will tell you for free, he gave us an opportunity as a county assembly not to go home, but to have an opportunity to work with him in some of the development cabinet. Because where we had reached, the only option the president had was to dissolve Nairobi County and to move. But we want to thank the president. And General, we were at State House. It was on Saturday. The president met 120 members of both sides, and he promised them that Nairobi is one county assembly that will have to remain as a handshake assembly. And therefore, the issues of politics, when we arrive at that door, when we enter in, we know that we are a handshake house that wants to see development within Nairobi. I know the challenges we are going to face, General, is one. You're supposed to make the deal, and I want to tell you the deal will pass. I know we passed it. I know we even moved that we have now given public service, and I need to look for the, we will get you the answer. because we moved in past, but we now agree that public service can now move the staff to enemies. But we are going to redo it again so that when we go to the judge, we will take it to the judge knowing now we have done what she has asked within her orders. The other thing I know we are going to be hit so hard, and that's why we have fought, is that sometimes we might disagree on some of the issues the external cartels will want. And that is the fight of this Nairobi County. And even within NMS, I want to plead, Jen, that you have to look at your staff and tell them, Nairobi County is a very interesting county where people come with money and in 1 second you lose focus completely of what you wanted to do because they have just put you in the pocket. Then you have officers, cartels, like one of the things they thrive in is recording. And therefore when they come to your office, do not allow them in your office.
Or with Luciola Major and then talk to them because they like recording. The recording will now go for selling. The next thing, they will come and tarnish the whole NMS. One person will make the whole thing turn and they will turn around and tell the president, you see, your president, we told you there are cartels. You see, even in NMS, they have arrived. So as we are saying, General, we are going to pray because we know that is the demonic spirit in Nairobi that takes over things on phones and everything and then transforms into an evil thing because of the businesses they thrive in. We are going to pray to God, to Allah, to take care of you, to give you the wisdom of how Nairobians will see that change. Nairobians will see calmness. Nairobians will see a spirit that one another are brothers and sisters. That is what we want. Lastly, General, we are going to create a framework, and I know the chair is creating that framework. We will hand it over. We don't want this back and forth of letters. We want your office to create a platform that is digital, and we shall just be sending. A member can just write, I'm the member of Quarry Road, I have a problem with the pipes. Like, I know Rose needs a lot of hardcore for a road. She has really cried. I've sent you all the photos. And I hope they can fill that road so that the people of Quarry can pass. But we want a form where they fill in 3 priorities every time. We forward to you. You are able to say this you can do and this you can't do. And you send it back. And we are creating a liaison office so that also your officers, those who will agree with you, can come sometimes to answer a few questions within the committees of the functions that have come to the national level, so that we abide to Article 187B, which is the county government still remains in terms of monitoring the implementation of the projects. So I know the National Assembly will give you the budget, but they will look and they'll be able to move and oversight for you and even help you to tell you here, kuna shamba ya county imachukuliwa. Hapa, kuna mali ya county, so that you are able to bring back. And we are there to support you, General. And with those few remarks, I now invite you to come and speak to this gallery. And karibu sana, General.
Honorable Speaker, please be seated. The Assembly leadership, it is a great honor this evening for me to visit this great place. The Assembly has its own history. And as a military officer, you always read the background before going to the place, so I've read a lot. I know I've not met personally each and every one of you, but I've heard your cries. I was appointed by His Excellency on 18th of March. I was actually told on 17th of March at night that tomorrow you are going to be appointed this position. So I had no even flexibility to think. But I just came head on and took the task. Being a military officer, and by the way, I had the agenda law too here. I'm still a serving general, and the only reason I could not come in uniform because it would change my capacity if I came in full combat. I also had the Air Force One. I was a pilot of Air Force One.
Yes,
and I don't remember carrying him in Air Force One. So it's a great pleasure. Unfortunately, it came at a day when some of our Nairobi constituents suffered a huge fire in Gikomba. As we are talking, there are 399 households without a home. It is so unfortunate. When I came in NMS, it's what we would call in Swahili, nimetupa kwa matope, so deep, and I had no gunboats. Because immediately I came in, I'm not a politician, I don't understand politics, and I don't wish to know the politics. So to me, when I hear the government side and the opposition side, those are strange terminologies. Because to me, you are all Kenyans, and as a uniform personnel, I serve all of you without thinking of so one thing I assure you, I do not take sides. Whatever you present to me will be achieved. Madam Speaker, I want to tell you, I'm not afraid of being tapped. And I will not stop them with their telephones. When they come to my office, let them also bring cameras. Because I believe in transparency. So if you want to tap me, please tap me till the day I resign. I have nothing to hide. I deliver what I'm given. Mine is not politics. Mine is service delivery. So I'm here as your servant. And I can assure you, I will work throughout to ensure that all your words are developed. I will not take sides, but my only humble request is please set your priorities. You know that the budget we are given is not enough to cater for each and every aspect that you want. So I will do my level best to ensure that there is a change in each and every ward. Regardless whether you support me or not, mine is not to serve you as a member, but to serve the constituents who brought you to this assembly. All of them, all of us are Kenyans, and they have a right. It is not a favor. So when you come to my office, you are not asking for a favor, you are asking for a right, remember. That is what makes the difference between the leadership which was there and now. To me, whatever you have, that is your right. So you must demand it from me. You do not come and ask me. And I assure all of you that whatever you demand, I will deliver within the constraints of the budget. So please, let's help each other. We must set priorities. Look at the most hurting projects that even your constituents will appreciate. There are a lot of services that the common mwananchi of Nairobi has never seen. There are areas they've never seen a drop of water. Let's make that change. There are areas they've never seen accessible roads. Let's change those. There are areas where there has been no electricity. Let's make a change. So together we can work to deliver all these services that every Mwananchi deserves. And one of the legacy of His Excellency the President is to make sure that every household within Nairobi County is almost equal in their service delivery. So we must make sure, whether you are coming from Mathare, whether from Mukuru, Korokocho, Kibra, those ones must live the same life like the ones we are currently living at home. So it's not fair that people in informal settlement get less than the ones in the settled settlement. So mine, I might look a bit biased, but I'm going first to that Mwananchi who's suffering the most before coming to the Mwananchi who's living comfortably. There you'll have to excuse me. My priority is to change all the informal sectors. We have started with Mukuru, and we are going to Kibra, we are going to Mathare, we are going to Korokocho, and all the other informal settlements to make sure that life changes there. For the people of Mukuru, I think they've been seeing me, and I work every day, for those who know me, up to 10 o'clock at night, every single day, including weekends. So I come and visit your areas most of the times. I don't consult you because I want to see for myself what's there on the ground. So when you come to my office, I know what you need. Last night, we went around with His Excellency, and he saw for himself several of your wards. All of you are sleeping. But he actually sympathized with what your words contain. He has tasked me not to get comfortable sleep until your constituents can sleep comfortably. So that's the task I have. It's a heavy task, but I assure you, if we work together, will be able to achieve a lot. So let's prioritize. Don't be selfish. If you get one project, do not come demanding for seven others when you know the budget will allow only for maybe three projects in this financial year. Let everybody get the share of the cake. That's the only. And I can assure you, I'm finishing my first 100 days this Sunday, on 28th. I was given certain targets to achieve within 100 days, certain targets to achieve in medium term, the next 6 months. And as I was driving around with His Excellency last night, I showed him that I had passed the 100%. I've already started doing the midterm projects, which I'm going to be handed over next Monday, next Tuesday. But this is the only way. If we join hands, we'll be able to achieve a lot for this county. This county has suffered quite a lot, but this is the time for turning, and Nairobi County will never look back. All I can say now, I did not come here with a prepared speech, but all I would like to say is to urge you that we work together through your leadership and the Honorable Speaker. I will hear all your requests, and I assure you, you don't have to see me. I will serve you with all your requests. Was just to come and greet you and tell you that my working time is not over. I'm still going round now to inspect projects up to maybe 9 o'clock, then that's when I drive home. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to interact. I would like to say that my office has an open door policy. Any one of you can come, but I also look at my military etiquette, that you don't see everybody. If anything has to go, it must go through a system. You have your leadership here, you have the Honorable Speaker, please put your request through her, and I can assure you, if I don't achieve, call me here to answer on what I have not achieved. But I have promised you, from today onwards, we will work to ensure that all your areas improve. We may not achieve 100% this year, but by next year, we will have surpassed our targets. And I would like to beg you all, please help me surpass this target. If we are given 100%, let's show His Excellency that if we join hands, we can do even 200%. It is achievable because I've learned one thing since I came to the county. You know that you passed the supplementary budget just last week. Was it? It was signed last week. What am I going to do with 3 billion and I'm returning it on Tuesday? But that did not stop me. I can tell you, I borrowed that 3 billion. This is what you see in Nairobi done. You think, or whoever thinks has failed, he himself has failed. Because whatever you pass is going to pay back that loan I took. So I've already achieved it. And I can assure you, even if you block, I will borrow and you will pay for it. This is not a county to sabotage each other. We all live on it. If you sabotage this country, where will our children go and live? Do you want them to migrate? We are not a migrating community. So let's live in Nairobi. Let's change Nairobi. Thank you very much and God bless you.